We at war. We at war with terrorism, racism, but most of all, we at war with ourselves. God, show me the way because the devil's trying to break me down.
ROTC is leadership training. It helps you with leadership skills, and you learn how decision-making skills.
Confidence in their abilities. We work a lot on critical thinking and time management and all the things that a leader needs to do, usually in a time-constrained or difficult environment. And I think that's the biggest thing that students can take. Even if they don't complete the full 4 years and achieve a commission, they still walk away with a lot of skills. It is hard work and dedication, but it doesn't feel that way. It starts to feel fun. If you ask any athlete, a runner, you know, they enjoy running. And it's the same kind of thing. There's some hard work that you put into it, but it becomes a part of second nature. And you really start to enjoy it, and it starts to feel natural.
Being enrolled in the Army ROTC program, you participate in physical training in the morning, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday from 6 to 7. It's a great time to work out. It forces you to stay in shape in college. We do all kinds of things we run around, we have our Walmart loop, and there's also push-ups, sit-ups, other team-building exercises that strengthen and make good leaders who try to set the example.
In the beginning, it's really hard, but as you go on, it gets a lot easier, and you notice it in yourself that you're improving. You'll feel a lot better on the day-to-day basis. You'll be able to focus a lot better in class, and it'll just feel better overall. It's just a good feeling when you know that you're in shape and you can do normal activities very easily.
PT in the morning, it's not always hard work. We do some fun things in the mornings, like, you know, ultimate frisbee or football or, you know, stuff like that. It can be fun too. So,
I mean, there are some days that are harder to get up than others, but overall, it just becomes part of your natural rhythm, and it's not that big a deal.
Outside of PT, we do have some demanding weekends.
One, there's the Ranger Challenge Club.
It's hard work to get on it, but if you get on it, it's a real big honor.
They work out every morning, so they're a little harder than regular PT. PT is normally 3 days a week, and they work out 5 days a week. And they do different competition things within ROTC, and then they compete against the different schools around the area.
You practice basic infantry skills.
M16, assembly and disassembly. Also a 10K ruck march, which is a 6.2 mile run with 40 pounds on your back.
They have a rope bridge climb. You have to do well on your PT test, different aspects of that. There's also the color guard team, so at the Widener football games, we have the color guard marched on at the beginning of the football game, as well as the battery robinette.
With battery robinette, we fire off the cannon every time that Widener scores. And we also do push-ups for each point that they score. So it can get up pretty high if they have a high-scoring game. And everyone looks forward to it. It's just a great time. The ROTC program is really good for you because it teaches you life skills, not just military skills, but how to lead. And even if you're only in it for 4 years, when you get out, whatever you do afterwards, the leadership skills and management skills that you learn, will just be help you so much. It's just so incredibly beneficial. Even if you're not going to stay in ROTC, do it for the 2 years, just the classes, just to learn these skills.
Being in the Army ROTC program, I feel that people look up to you as, you know, you've taken that step, you want to serve your country, you're in leadership training, and it's very, Widener University is very welcoming to this Army ROTC program. We have over 60 cadets. Army ROTC also gives you the chance to travel. After my junior year, I got to do a nurse summer training program out in Hawaii, so that was a great experience, and I look forward to moving out to Germany in April to work as a nurse. So there's many opportunities in the United States as well as around the world to travel.
My overall experience with ROTC has been nothing but positive. It's been, it's really helped me with schoolwork, being determined to do things, and I think anyone could benefit from this program and join the Army. I mean, it's not hard, and it's really just great to do.
With ROTC, it's really good because when you come here, you're already in a group. You don't have to worry about finding where you fit in. Everyone in ROTC will take you in and look out for you. The friends that you make here will basically be brothers to you when you're here because you go through all the same stuff, you do all the same things, and you really just look out for each other whenever you need it.
The relationships that you build in the Army are fantastic. Someone sent me a quote a long time ago that said, civilian friendships come and go, but Army friendships last forever. And you can have a friend that you were very close with and then be separated for 10 years and pick it right up where you left off when you meet up again. So yes, they're very, you make very deep and lasting friendships in a very short period of time.
One word that I would say to summarize my entire ROTC experience would definitely have to be family. I mean, it's really great having like the 70 people here that are in ROTC that you can just call up and rely on when you know you get down on ROTC or schoolwork or anything. Times get rough. There's people there that you know you're really close with that you can call and connect with.
You really form that bond between you and your classmates. And I've made some great friends in the program who will be friends with me for the rest of my life.
I don't think anyone knows exactly what to expect when they come to an ROTC unit. The sergeants come through, usually they're drill sergeants, and so they've got a basic training mindset. We come out of the active Army, and we understand how soldiers work. But when it comes to students who are not yet soldiers, and you're training them to be officers, you don't really know what to expect. But once you get on your feet on the ground, you start to experience that same sense of fulfillment that we talked about, you know, being able to see someone transition from raw materials into a true leader is fantastic.